So today's book covers the trials and tribulations of a guy who has inexplicably transformed overnight into a monstrous vermin. As a radio producer and programmer and someone who makes their livelihood in the media, I have to ask, what's the big deal? We'll find out today on Book of the Day. Welcome back to the Thursday edition of Book of the Day here on CPL Radio. It is November 10th, 2022. I'm Jeff Messerman in Cedarburg, Wisconsin. Having a very remarkably warm November, as is, I know, Steve as well, out in Boston. And we both could probably use an exterminator, especially after today's book.
Or maybe not. If our hearts are in the right place. We are, of course, in case you were all of you flummoxed by the teaser opening, we are talking about The Metamorphosis by Franz Kafka.
Lovely cover. I've never seen that before.
This is the Susan Bernofsky translation. We also have the Michael Hoffman translation for Penguin Classic Deluxe Edition.
Oh, that's nice too.
You know, a cartoon there. It has cartoon flaps, a cartoon back.
It's nice.
Totally up in the air whether or not readers like a very pictorial, literal description of something or something like this. I love the fact that the letters here, for those who are watching and listening but not watching, in the Susan Bernofsky translation, the letters of the word metamorphosis have been positioned to look like an enormous bug. And there's also, I should also point out, the Korngold translation, which is, I believe, the translation for the Norton Critical Edition, which is also excellent. But this is... Well, this is a little over a century old. It's a thin novella. It will take you no time at all to read. And you will, once you lodge it in your mind, you will be grappling with it for the rest of your life.
Unforgettable.
It's what Camus said was that the whole of Kafka's art is that he forces people to reread him. And unlike everything else that Camus said, that was absolutely true. This is the story of a salesman named Gregor Samsa, who wakes up one morning to find that he is a bug, a giant man-sized bug. You will have a little war of the translators with various different editions. It was once upon a time very popular to translate Monstrous Vermin, which is my esteemed producer notes is the literal German. It was forever fashionable to translate that as cockroach, a giant cockroach. It isn't necessary. I myself think that Kafka had a different kind of vermin in mind when he was writing the story. But the point is, it's not metaphorical. The point is that it's not metaphorical. That's why this is the novella that has launched 1,000 dissertations, is that it's not metaphorical. It's not that Gregor Samsa wakes up and feels verminous. It's that he wakes up and he can't get up because his hard-shelled carapace is pinning him to the bed. And when his family sees him, they see a giant bug, and they're repulsed. And he can't go to work. He doesn't want to eat fresh food.
No.
Only rotting food. And he wants to hide under furniture when people are around. He is gradually, I think, the stroke of genius in the story isn't... Kafka had this way about him. He had a certain way about him. He had this way about him of just plopping the idea of a story in front of you and then plunging absolutely fearlessly into its depths. Take it as far as it will go. Take it to all of its conclusions. That lays bare, you know, all the aforementioned 1,000 dissertations. What man's self-loathing, the breadwinner's place in the family, of course, in the 21st century, 1,000 sexual interpretations. But the amazing thing about the book is that the event really happens. The event is not metaphorical.
I've been in a few arguments in a couple of classes. I've been through this before, and even the instructor went the route you mentioned earlier, where, well, perhaps, and he was floating out only as an option, but I felt like he believed it, this particular instructor, and said, oh, Gregor was just having an off day.
Right. And the point is that that would make this an easy story, and Kafka never gives you the easy way out. Never. Mm-hmm. It would be easy if this were a metaphorical transformation, if it represented, you know, 20s or 30s malaise. If it represented the disorders of the change of the millennium, you know, 1915, where everybody's thinking the world is about to end.
COVID-19. And you thought that was bad.
Yeah. It would be easy if that were this. Yeah. But that isn't.
No.
Gregor Samsa actually does transform into something that's not human. And the genius stroke, I think, of the book is not just that that transformation is not metaphorical. It's also that it's not complete.
It isn't
in an instant. He isn't a bug himself. He's still a human.
Right.
When he wakes up that morning. And gradually, not only at first is he disoriented because although he feels human, he knows he's not. And also because he can't make himself understood to his family anymore. But also because he feels that humanity slipping away.
Yes. Yes.
Slowly over time, he feels that humanity slipping away. He feels himself maybe even a little accepting and comfortable with whatever the alternative is.
Indeed. Oh, absolutely. You know, and I've heard people mention in the past that, could this ever be adapted for the screen? And I had to chuckle and say, it was. David Cronenberg's The Fly, 1986. We've been here.
It'd be a weird thing to do.
It would.
I can't imagine it myself. I can't imagine that it wouldn't be ruined. But that could
right.
just be the cynic in me.
Well, that and certainly I irritated this instructor even more by floating in class that I found the book very funny, and I think there is humor in there to be found. And he said he was
absolutely forbidden to see humor in this book. I don't know why. I have no idea why, but you are absolutely forbidden to see it. It is viewed as the pinnacle of tragedy. I don't get that.
And tragedy and humor certainly have never occupied the same space.
There's tons and tons of biographical readings into this thing from of Kafka's own self-loathing for a number of obvious reasons. If you read any of the furtive biographies about the man, it always brings me to the point that I am going to reach now with our viewers and listeners, which is ignore all commentary. Even the introductions to books like this or the Penguin Classic or the Norton Critical, ignore it all. This is a story about a man who transforms into a bug.
End of story.
Ignore all of the 1,000 dissertations and just read the book and then make your own conclusions. Trust me, no one who has ever interpreted this book critically will come to a better interpretation than yours. The only thing that you shouldn't do is take all of the easy back doors that I think Kafka firmly closes, the foremost being that this is some sort of extended metaphor. You shouldn't do that. Kafka asks himself, what would happen if you just transformed? What would happen if you changed into something that wasn't human? Or maybe you were headed along that way anyway.
Absolutely.
I won't give away the ending in case any 120 years haven't read this thing, but I'll just say the ending of the story, if we're going to toss around words like inhuman, that word certainly applies to Gregor Samsa's family at the end of this story.
I fear it ends.
He's not the only one.
There are no easy answers,
in other words.
I think it ends the only way it could. I don't see. I mean, and most people come away from that, and there are members of that same class I'm thinking of who said, well, why couldn't he just switch back? Like, what?
Why can't he switch back once he's done fighting Dr. Doom?
Right.
Or in the 21st century, Gregor Samsa's sister at the end of the story would turn into a bigger and far better don't need no man vermin. She would turn into an even more monstrous vermin who doesn't need a male vermin at all.
Sounds like a praying mantis to me.
I know, it's all just so boring. It's better by far. As I think is a theme on our Classics Thursdays, better by far to strip away all of the notes and just read the work yourself. These things were meant to be read. I'm not saying completely that Kafka's Metamorphosis was meant to be read and enjoyed, but it was certainly meant to get under your skin, and it will. Absolutely will.
Oh, it's haunting. There are haunting passages, and yes.
Think about all of the books that were written in 1915 that are trying to get under your skin and absolutely fail now. They feel quaint. God help us, quaint, a word that you could never use on Kafka.
No.
So there is power here, real present day power. Absolutely. So avail yourself of it. Absolutely. I shouldn't be waving this thing around because you have many translations to choose.
Oh, certainly. Certainly, yeah.
It's a complex work, very, very deep, but it is a comparatively simple work to translate. So you're okay with any translation that you pick.
And an easy read. I mean, really, once you wrap your mind around what's actually occurring.
Yep. It's what Camus said. It's an easy read and it's an infinite reread.
Oh, indeed.
You'll never be at peace with it. And that's great.
How dare he? let me ask you this. How was it received in 15? What did people think? 1915.
Well, I'm only 28. Well, I'm quite sure I don't know where that question comes from. But from the extensive archival reading that I have done.
Yes.
I think the impression I get is that it bamboozled a lot of critics at the time, too. And most of them, I think, leapt right away to what I insist the story does not allow, which is a metaphorical, allegorical interpretation. No. You have to ignore that and then find out where the story takes you, I think.
Absolutely.
But you know, it's been well over a century of people, not just in this story, but in any Kafka story, it's been well over a century of people trying to find a way to make him comfortable.
Oh, sure.
A way to let him into the front parlor so that he doesn't disturb quite so much.
Right, right. I mean, and the Metamorphosis is certainly a wonderful gateway into that frame of mind for the castle, the trial, all the things that, and, you know, woe be to anybody looking for easy answers or a guidepost for either of those books. So it's great.
That quality that I think in a lot of ways, I have often heard Kafka nominated as the ultimate 20th century writer. And it's that quality that I think would be the foremost qualification if we were to make such a thing, if we were to say such a thing. I think that would be it, is that he's irreducible. And never more so than in this little book.
Yes.
So your classic Thursday is a recommendation, but you're going to be rereading this for your whole life.
Well, we either I turned into a bug here. I'll snip that out. My lights went down. All right. Friends, we're sorry. we will wrap it up here and... And I would say you're welcome or I'm sorry. When it comes to the Metamorphosis, I'm not sure which. As Steve indicated, we may have set you down a path that's...
Assuming that the library is well-stocked?
No problem there. No problem there. I think the high schools tear into it, and because of it, we have to have copies available for that reason alone. But don't let that deter you.
No, and don't let the one sentence description, it's a book about a guy who turns into a bug, don't let that make you think that it's already your intellectual possession if you haven't read it or reread it in decades.
Right.
You owe it to yourself. It's disturbing, but it's a good kind of disturbing. Much like our show.
Indeed. I think we have proclaimed it the best man to bug book ever written. That's very possible. Is that a bold statement? Probably not. Anyway, we're back tomorrow with what I like to call, what we've been calling, I guess, Picture Book Friday. And that is exciting. And we hope you'll be with us as well. Thank you, Steve.
Thank you all.